Hello friends, I am Aryan and today I am here with my chess video, Chess Basics Part 2. In this video, we are going to learn about chess pieces and its movement. So let's start with the first piece, and this is pawn. And as we know, pawns are the smallest of all the pieces. The pawns is the only piece that cannot move backward, nor it can jump over the other man. The pawns move only forward, one square at a time, along with the file on which it stands. So let's start it. So I'm going to set this new board with only pawns on it. Wait. Now you can see all the pawns are placed. Here is the position. So now look, as I told you, pawns doesn't move backward, or it can't jump on over the other pieces. Every pawn, no matter how far the game has progressed, has a choice on its first move of moving forward either one or two square. We know pawns placed on the second rank and seventh rank can move two step or one step at any time of the game. It's completely depend upon the player. Okay, like this. Suppose I started with the e4. Black replied e5. Now I can play h3. Black played h6. But again I can play d4. Okay, like this. So it's depend upon the player. You can move it one step or two step from its starting rank. Okay, now we are coming on the capture. As we know, pawn used to capture in V shape, like this. Suppose this is the position, and you can see this black pawn can capture these two pawn. Pawn on D4 and pawn on F4. But this E5 pawn can't capture the E4 pawn, because pawn moves straight but capture in the V shape. Okay, this is the basic rule of pawn capture. Okay, like this. Here it is black to move. Black can capture this pawn like this. Again C3, black can capture this pawn. Again white can also take this pawn. Okay, so now you can see the pawn on F5 can't capture the F6 pawn, because this pawn is blocking the pawn on F5. A pawn can't jump over its opponent's pieces. Now suppose a black played G6, you can capture it with your F pawn. This. So it is very easy. You should remember, pawn can move two step or one step from its starting rank. It used to move straight, but it used to capture in V shape or slanting, only to one square. The limitation is one square. Okay, done. So now we are coming on rook. The movement of rook is very easy, actually. It's very easy. Okay, let me set the position. You can see in diagram ki the rook is placed on f1, h1, black's rook is placed on d8 and a8. Okay, so the rook can move straight anywhere like this, horizontally or vertically. This is very simple. Suppose I move this rook here like this, you can move this rook here. It can move straight anywhere, horizontally or vertically. But there is one more important thing. A rook can't jump over a other piece. Suppose we want to move this white's rook from h1 to h8, but you can't jump this black's pawn. You have to capture this black pawn first, and then in the next move you can move it on h8. Again, this black rook can capture the white's rook now. Okay, so this is very simple. The rook can move straight anywhere. You can't move this rook slanting like this. Look, I am trying to moving it here, but I can't move. This is illegal. Okay, so now the next piece is bishop. Friends, we know each side has two type of bishop. One bishop is light square bishop and second bishop is dark square bishop. Okay, like this. And bishop used to move in diagonals. Okay, so or you, we can say in normal language slanting. So this is the movement of bishop. You can move it in diagonal. Like rook, it will move straight only in diagonals. It can't move straight in vertically or horizontally. You should move it slanting in diagonals like this. This is light square bishop. It only moves on light squares like this. Look, this is dark square bishop. You can only move it in dark squares like this. Okay. Like this, this bishop from d4 can move anywhere in these squares. Look, all these squares are dark, but in a straight line only. You can't move it here. Suppose I want to move this bishop here, I can't move it because this is not a straight. This is a dark square, but this is not a straight slanting line, so I can't move it here. Okay. Same, you can move, a bishop can't jump another piece. Suppose I am placing a pawn or piece. Suppose here is the black's rook or white's rook, and here is the white's pawn. Now, if you want to capture this black's rook, you can't capture it because a white bishop can't jump on piece. You can see, I can't. This will be an illegal move. Okay. So, and here is the white bishop on the d4. This bishop can't move to d4 because it will be illegal because this pawn on c5 is blocking it. Okay. Now let's come on the queen. Okay. So queen is the strongest piece on the chessboard. As we know, the strength of a combined rook and bishop is equal to the queen. You can see this white rook can move anywhere like bishop, like light square bishops. You can move it. This white queen can move like light square bishop, like this, because it is placed on the light square, and it can move like a rook. So the combined strength of rook and bishop is equal to the queen. Okay, you can see this queen can move like light square bishop anywhere in diagonal straight line, and like a rook anywhere in vertical or horizontal lines. Now suppose this queen is on dark square. This queen can move on dark squares like the dark square bishop. Okay, and a rook like this. Like this. Again, a queen can't jump over a piece. Okay, so The movement of all these pieces are same, like they all can't jump over a pieces. Okay, you have to keep this in your mind that a piece can't jump over a piece. Okay, you can capture your opponent piece which placed in between the movement of your pieces. Dear friends, now we are coming on the knight, and as we know, knight is the trickiest piece. Okay, so now we are going to learn about this tricky piece. Okay, so knight used to move in L shape. Okay, like this, 1, 2. So this is 2.5 actually, 1, 2.5. Again, from here, 1, 2.5, like this. Okay, so it normally controls 8 square from center squares. Okay, so this is the again 1, 2 and right left. You can also say like this, 1, 2 right and left, 1, 2 right or left. So this is the movement of knight. A centralized knight can control 8 squares. Okay, and as you can see in the diagram, a knight placed on the dark square can only control light squares. Okay, so from here you can move this knight on d7. From here, from d7 you can move this knight on c5. From c5 you can move it on e4. So the L can be made anywhere horizontally or vertically. Okay, but it should move 2 steps straight and then 1 step right or left. It's very simple actually. If we practice it, this is very simple. If we practice it, this is very simple. Look, same, this black knight can move. Look, this is very simple. The knight's movement are tricky. Now you can capture this knight. So the movement of knight is also very easy, but you have to practice it. Okay, now we are coming on the king. Okay, the king, the real hero of the chess game. Actually, without king you can't play it. Without king you can't continue a game. So the first basic rule of king's movement is you can't place two kings in front of each other like this. Suppose I played this, this is an illegal move. Okay, there should be a gap of 1 square between the both king. Okay, number two, a king can move 1 square or 1 step anywhere from its initial position or from its present position. Okay, like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So a king can move 8 squares. Okay, so or normally we can say a king can move 1 step. Okay, in one time. So like this, like this, like this. But there should be a gap of 1 square between the both king. A king can't come on a square where opponent pieces are controlling, have control. Okay, suppose I'm going to include a piece here. So I include some pieces. Now look, the black's queen is controlling this whole rank. Okay, it is also controlling the a2 ga diagonal. So king can't come here, it will be an illegal move. Okay, I can't move it here. This will be an illegal in normal match, and you will lose the match. So you have to take care of it. You have to move your king where opponent pieces doesn't have control.